I'm representing Amnesty International. Amnesty International is one of the biggest organizations for human rights protection around the world. What is happening right now in Greece, I think it's one of the worst situations of human rights in Europe right now, if not the worst one. And I'm referring to the situation of refugees. I want to start by trying to give you the general perspective. It's really, you know, weird or funny, even if you can say that it's something like that, it's funny, to think about how people, how European governments react or do not react or face the refugee issues here in Europe, and especially when you have to compare the numbers of the people who are coming to Europe and the number that big European countries actually host as refugees or asylum seekers, comparing to the rest of the world. In that way, and this is really interesting to see, then you can find the UNHCR data to see countries with very limited capacity, with very limited economic resources, that have to host one or two or even three million refugees and asylum seekers, while at the same time here in Europe, you see countries hosting 100,000 people or even 50,000 people, and they believe that they are living in a situation of crisis. And what makes it even worse to think about is this big contradiction that at the same time Europe, as an economic territory, is one of the richest and the most affluent in the world, while at the same time you see this big contradiction that the help, the solidarity that they show to people looking for dignity and safety for themselves and their families. And this is one of the worst points. What Europe does right now, it actually implements a policy that has a lot of similarities with other regions in the world. Is this policy, this strategy actually of the externalization of borders. What they are actually doing by that is that they are actually purchasing, and I'm using this word in particular, they are purchasing their obligations in terms of human rights and in terms of respect of international law and the refugee law, because they do have the money, the European Union. They give this money to countries that don't have the same resources or the same economic capacity as in the case of Libya or in the case even Turkey. And in that way, they are telling to these countries, you are responsible for this problem that we don't want to deal. And in that way, they are creating front yards in order to deal with responsibilities that the European countries should have dealt. This is the case since the March of 2016. And as it seems, things are getting worse and worse, especially here in Greece, that we see all the consequences of this induced, underline it, crisis, in brackets. It's exactly the case that we see this abysmal situation conditions in the islands, where we see about 40,000 people right now. 40,000, it's difficult for me to say it, in the islands, being trapped, being actually in camps that operate as open jails in conditions that everybody knows. At the same time, as it was referred previously, you know very well there was a law initiative in the last month, month ago actually, that passed from the Greek Parliament that actually moves on the very on the limits, and some cases it trespasses the limits of European law and refugees law. What actually this brings with it is a lot of cases that are actually trying, and this is the philosophy of this law, they are trying to make the access to asylum hard, to make it harder for the people who really want to apply their right to ask for asylum. And they do it in a lot of ways, either through bureaucracy or through detention or through other practices that this law is full of. And in our point of view, and we have submitted, us and a lot of other organizations for human rights, have submitted our comments and our condemnation, actually, criticism of this law. Not only because it's a law that actually violates the basic human rights standards that we all of us try to protect, but at the same time, even in terms of in managerial practice, it won't be efficient and it will create a number of problems that it's supposed to solve them. From our side, detention is one of these big problems that have to do with this law. It's not normal to discuss about keeping people in detention because they are just asking for asylum, because these people have done nothing wrong. We're not talking about people who have been rejected and they are about to send back to another country. We're talking about people who are waiting in the line in order to get the application processed. At the same time, we have a lot of issues that have to do with the cutting of the economic and social rights of asylum seekers in Greece. Either it has to do with education or employment or even health. And one issue that really worries us a lot is the issue that has to do with deterrence in the borders, this so-called monitoring and controlling of the borders that most of the times is synonym with pushbacks. And pushbacks in the Aegean are lethal, as you may know.
And Evros.
And Evros, of course, yes, lethal. So from our side, what we believe that is now needed is a new migration policy in Europe. This is the cornerstone in order to deal with these issues. That the Dublin regulation that actually regulates the asylum policy in Europe has to be replaced, and has to be replaced and has to be reformed in a radical way, because it's important to establish a mechanism that shares equal proportionally the responsibility to all EU countries. I mean, we have seen in a lot of other aspects of political or economic life the way that these mechanisms work in terms of the European Union, and in our country we have felt it very much how these obligatory rules. So what we believe that when we're talking about human lives, it's important that the European Union should establish this kind of mechanisms. And this is the one pillar, and the other pillar has to do with what is happening here in Greece, and this is the responsibility of the Greek government, that it's really important to improve the conditions in the islands, move forward in creating conditions in camps in the mainland, and at the same time move forward in order to important steps in terms of integration in every level. So that's all from my side.